The Disappearance of Elena Thomas. No one knew why it started snowing in the middle of summer. The news, friends, family, no one in the small town of Bridgewater had any idea of what was going on. Meteorologists could not say where this strange weather had come from or when it would stop. The town officials didn't know what to do about the rising snow or about how to get supplies to outlast the storm. The only thing anyone knew was the same thing that everyone cautioned. Stay inside. Out in a cabin by the woods north of Bridgewater, three teenage girls strapped themselves up to ignore the advice they would have been given if they had bothered calling their parents. There was no time to ask for permission. Someone from their group was missing. Elena Thomas had gone out alone earlier into the woods to think, she had said. Despite the fact that it was a girls' weekend, her friends gave her space, knowing that she could handle herself. It had now been 2 hours since then, and 20 minutes had passed since the girls had noticed the weather. Once they had realized, however, Claire West mobilized her friends with a ready purpose.
We're not going to get pneumonia or something, are we?
Asked Jane Barry as she put on a second pair of gloves.
No,
said Rebecca Porter with a sigh.
We'll freeze to death before we get sick.
She finished putting on the sole pair of boots in the cabin, and she tried out a few steps. The girls were otherwise still dressed in summertime clothes, and could only outfit themselves with some spare things that had been left in the cabin from previous trips. There weren't any coats or scarves, and only Jane had thought to bring a jacket. Claire put on a frumpy old sun hat.
You guys worry too much,
she said, moving towards the door.
We face tougher problems than a random, mysterious blizzard. We just gotta check it out, make sure it's not something big, and make sure Elena's all right. Well, I was thinking,
Jane said quietly,
what if it's another gifted?
Rebecca put a hand on Jane's shoulder.
Bridgewater is ours,
she said resolutely.
We marked it on the last Congress. No one's gonna come here and cause trouble, unless they want war.
Outside, the snow had piled up high enough to impede walking. It fell thickly, and something about its shimmer seemed especially strange. As the girls went forward, Rebecca measured the distance in her mind.
Well,
she said after a bit,
this should be far enough away from the cabin. Can you see anything, Jane?
Jane closed her eyes, trying to calm her already shivering body. She inhaled deeply and outstretched her hands before reciting some arcane verse which gave her voice an ethereal cadence. Everything grew still around Jane. Snowflakes held themselves in the air as if they were mesmerized by her. After a moment, Claire and Rebecca felt a familiar disruption, a jittery, transient kind of feeling, as if something soft had brushed against their souls. The snowflakes in the air moved aside graciously to make way for Jane's visitors. A few freezing seconds passed before at last Jane opened her eyes, revealing an uncanny light within them. She pointed north to the woods, and trepidation etched itself onto her face.
They tell me she went that way,
Jane said.
Good,
Rebecca exclaimed.
That's where we expected her to go, right? Let's get moving. Wait,
Jane said, a nervous quickness in her tone.
She was with someone. They said it was a boy.
Claire's brow raised. Her eyes became wide, and she exchanged looks with Rebecca, who was just as concerned. Slowly, Claire repeated the words.
A boy?
She said.
Here? Now? But I didn't sense anything, except for this freaky blizzard. An Omega.
Rebecca growled, her lips tight with anger.
He must have done something to the fountain.
Claire shut her eyes and her jaw clenched. She felt the world around her and then closed her mind's grasp onto her own body, as if she were holding herself in the palm of her hand. Opening her eyes to reveal her own inner light, Claire took charge.
Get moving,
she said.
I'll scout ahead.
Rebecca gave her a stoic nod.
Don't do anything reckless,
she said, before she went up to Jane, who had climbed onto her back. Rebecca put herself into a ready stance, like a runner at a meet. She seemed entirely unbothered by Jane's weight. With a breath, her eyes snapped open, and their light shone forth as she pushed off the ground. Once Rebecca got into her rhythm, her strides became blurred, and a sense of power enveloped her. She kicked through the snow with ease as she darted towards the woods, not bounding daintily like an animal, but rather shooting forward like a locomotive. Claire watched them go as she tried to steady herself. She didn't like flying. It hurt to use her gift on her own body, but she had no choice. The last time an Omega came to Bridgewater, it had been bad. People died. Elder Margaret used all of her strength to make things seem normal again, and then she died too. Elena was the one who had stopped the Omega back then, and she was the one who had lost the most in the fight. So why would she ever let another boy come this close to the fountain? Claire had to find out. She steeled herself and let her gift pull her into the snowing sky. She turned her gaze northwards, where Rebecca and Jane were already gone out of sight. With an iron will, she used her mental grip to push her body forward over the woods. As she made her way to the fountain, she prayed that she would find Elena anywhere else.
"Not there,"
Claire whispered through grit teeth.
"Not